हेलो हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, जस्ट अ क्विक पर्टिकुलर वीडियो अबाउट हाउ टू प्रेजेंट द आंसर्स इन अ केस स्टडी बेस्ड क्वेश्चन. इन फैक्ट मेनी ऑफ यू आर अवेयर ऑफ इट. इट्स स्टिल एज अ लास्ट रिसोर्ट. आई जस्ट पुट दिस पर्टिकुलर थॉट इन द ऑन द रिकॉर्ड. सो आई टेक जस्ट कपल ऑफ योर मिनट्स टू जस्ट हाईलाइट अपॉन हाउ डू वी एड्रेस द केस लॉ पार्ट. बिफोर डूइंग दिस स्टूडेंट्स, अगेन जस्ट quick reminder about the dream team batch and an academy. Now all the star faculties for every subjects would be taking across you very exhaustively in the most decisive way to prepare your CA final course. Direct tax I will be taking across it, along with that international taxation paper number 6E. So those direct tax I'm starting on 12th of May, and international taxation also around the same point of time. So my target attempt would be May 22 attempt, November 22 attempt. These are the two attempts which I'm going to target through those particular batches. So this is about the batch. I'll suggest to for students that you take the subscription for CA Final Group 2 for 1 year at least. By taking the subscription for 1 year, you get access to all the Group 2 papers. 15,500 is the fees. You put the code, referral code CADS here, and you get 10% further discount. 10% further discount, students, and that exactly is the best part so far as this scheme is concerned. Now, students, coming on this particular proposition, as I told you, I already also said to the students, I'm just again repeating it, reminding it to all of you. The case study. The case law based first, I'll suggest to you write the name of the case law if you know the name. Name of the case law. Along with that, you should also write what it held, what was held, what was held. So, like for example, any particular case law which has been there, like for example, a case law on, say, Subrata Roy Supreme Court. In that case, we can say that whether the High Court was correct in taking away the order while the SSE was being represented by his junior counsel. So that was an issue which was there in that Subrata Roy case, and we have concluded that the High Court should not have taken that particular. So you can just write like this, that the High Court in Subrata Roy case has held that where the SSE was represented by his lawyer or junior counsels, then it is incorrect on the part of the court to take back or to remand back the case. Not remand back, you can just say to recall its own order which was passed by it previously. So that is how you should write the name, along with that quickly what it was held. Second would be the analysis of the case. This is the most important one. Why I am saying point number one, directly write the name, because at least it tells the examiner that you know the case law. Second point would be, and you should write the point also, and please write like this, analysis. Point, you'll say, what about the point number one? The case law. Like that, you can write the header. Point number two, analysis. This is all the key points. So here are the key points of the judgment. Should be reproduced. And the third one again. Conclusion. Now this conclusion should be linked up with the facts. with the facts given in the question. You'll say how to link it up, sir. As I told you, students, like you can say that in the present case, the SSC was being represented by the junior counsel. SSC was represented by the junior counsel. Thereafter, the High Court, after hearing the junior counsel, has passed the order. Accordingly, recalling its order, is unconstitutional, is invalid. Since the ground for the recall is only when the order that has been passed is an ex parte order. So the point what I'm trying to say is about, students, put this three particular fragmentation for writing of your case law. Now those who don't know about the name of the case law, they should avoid then point number one and two and three is what they need to write. Or in point number one, if you don't know the case law, what was the name? So at least write issue under consideration. So issue under consideration is what you will write as point number one when you don't know the name of the case law itself. So what was the issue which is there? At least that would be known to you. Now once that issue has been written briefly, then you do the analysis and do the conclusion. That is how you will end your case studies or case law based question. This is a 3 point. And you have to write the header the way I have made you refer over here. You have to write the header like this. Got this one, students? See you then, students, in the next segment. Thank you.